Tonight we welcome a folk stomp band from Sonoma County called Mr. December. They blend old time, rag, bluegrass, swing, country, and folk with a dash of punk rock edge. Tonight we'll get to know the members of the band for a while, and later we'll catch them play some music. Please welcome to the program our new friends, Mr. December.
Mr. December.
Hello.
He's sexy.
All right, I have a question. It's very fun when you Google Mr. December, because you're like, I wonder, like, if this is a reference to like a play or a song or something a long time ago. And you go to Google image search, and I don't know if you've ever Googled your band's name, but all you get is a bunch of shirtless men, sometimes pantless, in calendars, Mr. December, because it's like Mr. January, Mr. February, Mr. March.
I've never seen
that's,
that.
That's our gift to you.
And thank you, by the way. And my question is, did the band get named that because of that funny thing, because Mr. December is a name of the models in nude male calendars?
Definitely.
Yeah, it's from that movie, right?
We think it's really funny that calendar guys exist.
Yeah.
That there are guys out there who are, like, take it super seriously, and that's humor to us. We think that's hilarious. So when he said it's a gift to you, that's really what it is. When you Google Mr. December and it's like, what?
I was smiling.
We just think
ear
it's funny.
I was smiling
we
ear
just
to
think
ear.
It's funny.
I was
dudes
smiling ear
that.
To ear. And I would also like to say that I'd like to push back. And I'd like to say that the way that you laugh, you know, you're laughing at these men, these calendar men.
Totally.
But you know, their bodies are their art. Okay, your music is your art.
And
now,
enough.
I'm hearing a theme here.
Yeah.
There's a lot of art.
Now it's like it's a little bit more. What's the word when something's there and then it's not?
Ephemeral.
Yeah, their art is a little more ephemeral, like graffiti art. It's not going to last forever.
That's true.
This band seems like a project that kind of is in the background of your lives, but brings joy every once in a while. Like, you guys don't play every week or even every month. But you're there. Like, if you go through your online presence and stuff outside of Google image search, you know, you see that you play, what, like five times a year, six times a year, something like that?
We're a lot more prolific
than
that, for sure. But it's a lot of, I'd say, private stuff. We just kind of float from one thing to the next, really. Yeah. Like, one gig begets another gig, and then something else happens out of that. We just kind of follow threads more than anything.
We probably play 3 to 5 times a month.
Really? Yeah. So you do a lot of private stuff.
Yeah, then. We do winery mostly. Gigs, we do weddings, we do private parties.
And, but you have and sweet then we gigs do besides.
We do stage shows, and we have a regular at a few.
Yeah, the stage or club shows are more irregular for sure.
Yeah,
so I would say probably maybe around 6 a year. Something
six
like that.
Stage shows.
Yeah, if that's what you're saying for shows. That's probably pretty
accurate.
From
my vantage point, as somebody who's just doing research on the band coming up into this thing and just like paying attention to who plays around, you guys don't play terribly a lot on like public advertised bills.
Right. Well, it sets the bar low. That's when people come out, they're like, wow, they sound pretty good for not playing ever. These guys, good job.
Little do they know that we have provided background music to so many private events.
Yeah.
Well, and that's the nice thing about this, because it is accessible. So many people have bands that are not accessible to the public, and then nobody wants to pay them to come play their winery gig for $500.
And we worked really hard in college to put out music that no one really liked, and so we quickly learned that, you know, so that's partly why we don't try super hard, is because we kind of just got over it.
Okay, so you two folks were in bands in the 90s, and I would imagine maybe some punk rock?
Yeah.
Just for fun, names of bands? Just because punk band names are fun.
The Bionic Band would have been the one that played this stage couple times.
Yeah.
Cool. Before that, we don't talk about this.
High Pie.
Ever.
Horrible name.
High
Horrible.
Pie.
Yep.
High Pie. That's C-H-A-I-P-A-I.
Stupid.
Yeah. Is it stupid?
It was stupid.
Why is it stupid?
We had songs like...
High Pie.
Oh, well, we can just stop you right there.
totally.
I mean, the wineries might be listening.
That's true.
You got to cut that.
The Mondavis are regular listeners to the program. So having had that experience, was it tough for you two to make the transition to playing music that is not like, you know, you can't put us in a box, we're a punk band, to basically playing music that wineries are paying you to play? I know that some of my friends have a tough time, like, I don't want to play a winery, even if they're going to pay us some money, because it's just like, I don't like the crowd. I don't like the vibe. I don't like the feel.
We don't necessarily enjoy every element of playing at the wineries, but what it does is it gets us together outside of our normal lives, and we have beers and we have a great time.
And
it facilitates those good times.
Do any of the lyrics in any of the songs really feel relevant or pertinent to you guys? I know for me, as I was listening to them, there's a song you guys have about money, I think. Mm-hmm. That one, I don't have the lyrics in front of me, but it felt relevant because, you know, we've all probably seen the ill effects that wealth and money can have on a person's soul. Mm-hmm. And I think that song touches on that a bit, unless I'm just projecting onto that song.
Well, no, that's the great thing about lyrics is you project yourself onto it. Yeah. You know, the song becomes yours. It's not ours. I mean, once it's out there in the world, it's... shit, man, it means something different to everybody, and it has to, and it's great. That's what's great about music.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But money does disappear.
Yeah, God, what is that song all about?
Yeah, that's a good question.
Does anybody know?
who wrote Tom? That song?
You know, Jimmy. Look, I've never had it, so I don't really relate.
It's like hearing a song in Portuguese.
I don't know. Money.
It feels good.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds good. But
yeah.
Any insight from the songwriter?
On that particular song?
Yeah. Well, because he asked, you know, and he's a band member. It'd be good for him to know.
The way the songs come to me, this one also, I just start and it goes, and then it is. You know, I don't really put too much like cognitive, like intentional thought behind it. Just some words come together in a group, and then I say, oh, it kind of has an identity, and then it continues. And this one, money, it disappears. It's, you know, sort of right in your face. Just you can't hang on to it because you always got to buy shit. And then there's the government little line in there too. Yeah. But there's kind of the story is like, hey, I found a place and I really like it, but I don't know how to pay for it. And there's a little bit of a nod and a wink to, you know, the green economy and I didn't intentionally do that, but I think of that sometimes, you know, like just you can't tell people how you're actually paying for your house because you're in the green economy.
Yeah.
But then, you know, then there's also the kind of, I mean, there is some truth in it in that, you know, my grandfather, Charlie Horn, always told me if I save 10%, I'll make it, you know, I'll have a retirement or whatever. Anyway, so there's that line in there about, you know, just, you know, he told me to save 10%, but after the food and after the bills and the government, I ain't got shit really is kind of, I mean, that's it.
The other one, I mean, we don't have to go every song, but that one grabbed me.
There's only 80.
And, you know, maybe yeah, there's only 80. Well, I mean, we'll get comfortable. No, you have a song, Change is Coming. You repeated that chorus a few times.
Yeah, yeah. Big Eyes.
Big Eyes. Tell me a little bit about that song, because as I was filming it, because I film these things too,
yep.
I grabbed my phone and I sent myself an email, Change is Coming, because I wanted to talk about Change is Coming. But now I forget what that song's about. Mm. So what is the general vibe of that song? Because something grabbed me about it while you were performing it.
Oh, golly. Well, that song in particular, actually, and this doesn't happen often, but it's two songs that I had for many years that I put together. So the front half of it is just kind of a relationship thing. And then the second half is really, I think, mostly just about how change is coming and how fearful it is to be wrapped up in the wave of change, you know, and that... people talk about it, and I don't know. Change.
you know why? I just remember why. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, no. That I mean, that's. I feel like that's just kind of the essence of it. Is it's coming, and people talk about it, but then they also don't talk about it, and it's scary. So.
Now I remember.
That's
why
I'm
that
running. You know, that like the line of like, and now I'm running. It, change is coming.
Referenced it earlier. Ephemerality. Change is coming. Mm. Tom, you've always been sort of a fan of that,
as
of the ephemerality of graffiti art, of the fact that things change.
Yeah.
I remember one time I was talking to you about something that happened, like a death or a relationship ending, and you had a very like zoomed out sort of like, hey, that's the way life goes.
That's the way it goes.
And it can be frustrating for people to hear that when they're in like the hurt phase of being affected by change.
Then it seems like I'm just, kind of passing it off. But yeah, change is always going to happen, I think. And for me, I think I had one of the best lessons in it, and just watching Christo put his fence up across Sonoma County. and realizing they put all of this energy and all of this money into this project.
Can we tell people what that is?
Oh, Christo's Fence?
Oh, yeah.
So back in maybe 73 or 74, I was just out of high school or just getting out of high school.
In Sonoma County.
This artist from France comes to Petaluma, has a barbecue at the fairgrounds, gets most of the ranchers in the county to this barbecue, gets everybody drunk, feeds them really well, and then tells them he wants to lease their property to put a curtain from Cotati out to Bodega across the mountains. And it was this white, and I was just, what? That's the stupidest thing I've ever. You're going to do what? And of course nobody's going to lease you. And they did. He got the permits and the leases to put this curtain across Sonoma County, and it was only going to be up for a few months. What a terrible waste this would be. But what an incredibly beautiful thing it was to see live, shimmering in the wind across our green hills. It was just, wow. Mm. And you could cross under it driving the road out Bodega, or driving some of our county roads, and you could see it go out into the ocean. It was just, whoa, it blew me away. And the fact, when it finally dawned on me, this is only going to be here for a short period. Wow. Mm-hmm. What a glorious project this is. And it was one of my first experiences, and it was just about time I was getting out of high school. Life was changing for me, and I see this beautiful shimmering piece that is only going to be here for a short while, almost like the leaves on a tree, almost like the way nature works, and it's four cycles. It's going to come, and it's going to go, and it's just, wow. It was, to me, it was stunning and beautiful and really moving, and it was one of those things that marked one of the first changes in my life. From childhood to adulthood was right about that time in my life, and it was graffiti art is that way. The moment a song is performed is that way, and a lot of what we do is really all about change, and nothing is going to be permanent.
And you guys maybe could speak on this better, and I'm kind of at the halfway point between the two sides of the table, but I don't know, getting to the point where you don't jump off anymore. You know, when you realize it's time to not jump into change and to do something different. That to me is an interesting thing, because we all have different options as we go through life, you know, and you can choose. You have a 2-year-old.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Is it only child?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I have one. And are you speaking about like growing roots and choosing your identity and running with it and kind of breathing life into that thing for as much as possible before it breaks and being less flighty?
Well, it's like, what is your identity? That's the core of it. It's like, is your identity to throw caution to the wind constantly throughout your entire life, or does your identity pivot and change?
I don't think people are one thing all their life. I mean, obviously, you know, in one moment when I was a 17, 18-year-old coming up here, like I was throwing caution to the wind and I was being super flighty because that's what I was doing in my life. And I took in so many experiences, and then and I would say now in like my young 30s, I'm 40 now, you know, I really started looking back on my life and I started thinking so much about it that I really kind of stopped consuming experience, it felt like, you know, to the point of kind of like I became super shy and I stopped talking at parties, I didn't dance, and you know, just crap like that,
right,
you know?
On schedule.
Right on schedule. Totally. So,
but did you fight that is my question.
Oh, I've been fighting it forever. And I feel like with you bring up my 2-year-old Iris, she'll be 2 this next Sunday, the 18th, just already to say, yeah. Anyways, there's a lot going like on paper. My life is, I feel like, amazing, you know, but the emotions involved in it are, I mean, just, I don't know, like all of us experience our ups and our downs. It's just hard to swallow. And so she, I guess, with that change of her coming, has really, I mean, people, parents talk about it, like the joy, like the day I had with her was just incredible, you know, playing on the slide and picking strawberries in the garden and telling her no and having her laugh at me, you know, just things like that. It's just, I don't know. So, I don't really know where you want me to go. When it comes to change, like obviously I'm in a big point of change, just like Jesse's in a big point of change. And so many of us are in a big point of change, and that doesn't change because change has come. But like, what is the cycle of that change? You know, like, do you fight it? Do you make it happen? Do you just roll with it?
It's different for everyone.
Yeah.
And, exactly. And that's why it's an interesting conversational point.
And it changes over time and in every moment, you know?
I mean, I don't have any greater point to this. It's just that we talk about change, and some change we can't control, and some change we push through because we feel like we have to. You know what I'm saying?
Totally.
Yeah. Well, and it's the kind of thing where, you know, some people make that choice, like, I'm going in this direction and I'm fighting for this, whether it's going to be a doctor or lawyer and all that crap, or if you're going to be a professional musician or something like that. But so much of life is improvisation and is acting, you know, kind of as a result of something that's happened. And, you know, just because you don't know what you want to do, I guess. If I were going to say something to my younger self, like, just because you don't know what you want to do doesn't mean that you're not going to end up in some really rad places, doing some really good things, meeting some awesome people, playing great music, and having great life experiences. I can't say that I'm disappointed in my life in any way at all. But when you're younger and you see the whole world out there and it's really intimidating and you don't know where you're going to go, it's daunting. You know, it can freeze you up. It definitely froze me in a lot of places. Mm-hmm. But mm-hmm. you know, you kind of got to walk off the cliff sometimes, I guess. I don't know.
Is that a learned thing?
Well, I'd say, you know, we've all taken lumps, and you got to take lumps, you know, and it gives you character, and you know, life isn't always going to be rosy, and you shouldn't want it to be that way. You shouldn't want to be comfortable. Art and beauty doesn't often come from a comfortable spot. It comes from, you know, being hungry. It comes from being broke. It comes from being in a place where you don't know anybody, where you know, we both moved up here to Sonoma County. You don't know anybody here. You just try to make your way. And I don't know, that was the scariest thing. And that's the scariest part of any life right now, at any point in your life. I mean, Tom, what if you moved to Nebraska next week?
You know, I had a great experience in Nebraska. So weirdly enough, and to the point of, you hit 40 and you get a little bit shy around people and stuff like mm-hmm. that, because that's about for me when that change happened also, mm-hmm. Being I can hang out here in this building and feel totally at home, but I can't do parties anymore. Mm-hmm. It flummoxes me to get in the middle of a large group of people that I do not know.
But it hasn't always.
No, I used to be pretty gregarious when I was younger. But as I got older, yeah, I just, I've gotten shyer. And that's a change and I think you're right on schedule with that, weirdly yeah. enough. But so the thought of a cool space in a small town in Nebraska, maybe doesn't scare me. Every once in a while, the thought of being snowed in and having nowhere to go and having no one that could say you need to be here now, that kind of sounds cool. And I think that can happen in Nebraska occasionally.
Well, and I guess I would push back, or I would like just ask you. You say that discomfort is what fuels art, and being poor and being hungry is kind of what sometimes makes...
What up? Yeah. Are you saying rich, affluent people can't do art? Is that what you're saying?
What I'm saying is,
you're hurting all the
them?
Rich listeners out there.
I know.
Yeah. Very insensitive.
No,
but I'm sorry.
Take so many young artists who have won a Grammy.
Yeah, no. My question was, how long does one force discomfort in order to be able to create?
I've been around people who make music that put themselves in a constant state of chaos to create creative moments for themselves, and that can be pretty tiring to be around.
Yeah.
Well, I think that there are some of us too who are always kind of in a state of discomfort, maybe not physically necessarily, but you know, where you're shy and you're awkward. I think that so many...
Let's keep talking about that. That'd be great.
it doesn't come off in the interview, by the way.
You don't see my chest shaking? Yeah. My nerves?
You're doing well. Go ahead.
Socially, I think that a lot of musicians, a lot myself included, I think sometimes you guys too, I mean, we're pretty close, of course, can pretty much talk about anything, but I think that our best voices and the best things that we say are through our instruments, less so than our words. I don't know. I my job makes me talk to people all day long, and I love it, and it's great, and it's fine. But I mean, the truth of what I try to say, I feel, comes out in just the silly little bass lines that I'm playing, you know? Trying to say those things too. I mean, we're always still trying to figure out who we are as we continue to get older, and you know, who do we want to be when we grow up? When do we grow up? Do we grow up?
I don't think you do.
Yeah.
And Tom, do you have any closing thoughts for our friends here?
I love it. Again, if you guys, if you can't end up at one of the exclusive parties that these guys play, try and get out there and see them play in a club.
This is a pan for the 1%.
All right, we're going to book a show. I'm
God
sorry.
Damn it,
we're
sorry. We'll play out more, I swear to God.
You have a very few chances if you don't get to go to these exclusive parties.
We actually just discovered that for a year we've had a business card that had a had a website that doesn't exist.
Actually,
and an email that doesn't work and no phone number.
This is why you know that you've got something that is good and has momentum, even despite all the barriers you've put up for people to get in touch with you. I mean, my God. No working website, no working email. You're still getting to play.
We found our way here.
Yeah, and that happened as well. And we're so glad that you did. Thank you guys very much for joining us tonight. This has been super cool.
Thanks a lot.
The interview is over, but the reason our paths crossed is about to begin. Next up, Mr. December plays a bunch of music. Thanks again, guys.
Yeah, you got
to
see it. It's great.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us. Cool.
Your skin is so soft, your love is so hot. It's got me running, got me wanting to skip on down to your block. Ooh, girl, you know I want to impress you. I want to say I cook and that I read books too. Oh, girl, I got a feeling for you. So jump that boogie, jump that boogie to me. Jump that boogie, jump that boogie to be. Oh, girl, jump the boogie, yeah. I look you down, you look me up. We tilt back, we go top spot ups, tops. Girl, I'm so glad you came to say what's up. So jump that boogie, jump that boogie to me. Jump that boogie, jump that boogie to be. Oh, girl, jump the boogie, yeah. It's true, there ain't nothing I wouldn't do just to get the chance to have a proper romance with you. So jump that boogie, jump that boogie to me. Jump that boogie, jump that boogie to be. Oh, girl, jump the boogie, yeah. I like to romance.
Hell yeah.
I like to get you out your designer pants. Girl, I'm so glad we had this chance. Jump that boogie, jump that boogie to me. Jump that boogie, jump that boogie to be. Oh, girl, jump the boogie, yeah. Jump that boogie, jump that boogie to me. Jump that boogie, jump that boogie to be. Oh, girl, jump the boogie, yeah. 'Cause girl, you know that it's true. There ain't nothing I wouldn't do just to get the chance to have a proper romance with you. Just to get the chance to have a proper romance with you. Just to get the chance to have a proper romance with you.
Hey.
disappears. Money disappears. Money disappears. You can collect a lot, but you'll probably not keep it in your pocket for many years. Money disappears. Money disappears. Money disappears. You can collect a lot, but you'll probably not keep it in your pocket for many years. Had me a home in Northern California. It's where I chose to lay my head. But so many things, well, I grew to adore them. Just how they'd be paid for could not be said. It could not be. Money disappears. Money disappears. Money disappears. You can collect a lot, but you'll probably not keep it in your pocket for many years. Working hard like my daddy's daddy taught me, and tried to save at least 10%. But after my bills and all the food for my family, the rest went straight to my good government. My good government. Money disappears. Money disappears. Money disappears. Money disappears. Money disappears. You can collect a lot, but you'll probably not keep it in your pocket for many, pocket for many, pocket for many years. Ferry boat, and don't worry, baby, it was designed to float. Put on your favorite sailing shoes and take my hand, you've got nothing to lose. I'm tired and hungry, I'm just a little tired and hungry. So many people, they try to will tell you what you need. So come with me and we'll have some laughs. If we can play captain, you can sit on my. We can take turns telling each other what to do. Is that your favorite sweater? Now it's mine too. I'm tired and hungry. I'm just a little tired and hungry. Ooh.
people. They try to will tell you what you need. So come with me on this ferry boat. And don't worry, baby, it was designed to float. We can take turns telling each other what to do. Is that your favorite sweater? Now it's mine too. I'm tired and hungry. I'm just a little tired and hungry. I'm just a little tired. I'm just a little tired and hungry. My sweet, what big eyes you had for me when you were young and wild and free. Those days, they seem to be a memory. A memory. Sometimes, well, I think that I live in a dream where there is you and there is me, hand in hand by the sea. As you lean into me, your breath, it seems to be a sweet melody. 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 D. Melody. Changes come in, changes come in. That's what they said, and I bet they're gonna blame it on it. Changes come in, changes come in. And that's why I started running. Yeah. Started running. I don't need it. Never wanted it, but now I got it and I don't know what to do with it. Could it be that it's not for me, and that I'm stuck because I'm too polite to be mean? I'm frustrated, but I guess that's life and I'm gonna have to take it. It's got me running, it's got me running, cause I heard that change is coming. Come in. It's coming. Many years ago, when I was young and fit, didn't matter how far the drive, to play my own music, I'd make the drive, cause I was fit, to make the drive, to play my own music, music, music,
Music. The sun, the stars, the moon, the boats, airplanes, and cars, the venues and saloons, the cafes and the bars. I'm headed home, 'cause I'm tired. I'm headed home, 'cause I'm tired. 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 I'm headed home, 'cause it's a lonely, long and winding road that I roam. 'Cause it's a lonely, long and winding road. Sometimes my plans are up, sometimes my plans are down. Sometimes I take my shoes off, plant my bare feet on the ground. I'm headed home, because I'm tired. I'm headed home to put my feet up by the fire. 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 I'm headed home, 'cause it's a lonely, long and winding road that I roam. 'Cause it's a lonely, long and winding road. Got some stories, seen some glory, but in the end I knew I'd always come back to you. 'Cause here's the truth, I missed you. Yeah, here's the truth, I missed you. 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 I'm headed home, 'cause it's a lonely, long and winding road that I roam. 'Cause it's a lonely, long and winding road that I roam. That I.
kitchen, cooking up a bone. Mama's in the kitchen and a papa ain't home. Turning up the oven, sprinkling the spice. She's all alone on a Saturday night, Saturday night. Everyone knows papa ain't home. What's mama doing with the lights down low? Shades are drawn, she won't pick up the phone. No, no, no. Oh, mama, she's cooking up a mama's in the kitchen, cooking up a bone. Mama's in the kitchen and a papa ain't home. Turning up the oven, sprinkling the spice. She's all alone on a Saturday night, Saturday night. Steaming up the rice, dicing the tomato, set the table just right. Pull out the vinyl, stick the needle in the groove. Mama leans back as she kicks off her shoes. Kicks off her shoes. Everyone knows papa ain't home. What's mama doing with lights down low? Shades are drawn, she won't pick up the phone. No, no, no. Oh, mama's cooking up a bone. Oven, sprinkling the spice, she's all alone on a Saturday night, Saturday night. Everyone knows papa ain't home. What's mama doing with the lights down low? Shades are drawn, she won't pick up the phone. No, no, no. Oh, mama's cooking up a mama. She's cooking up a mama. She's cooking up a.
Sipping on making a dime. Don't think I got it wrong to be sitting here singing my song. Sitting here in the cornfield, spending my time. My mama thinks I'm crazy, cause ain't got me a job. Daddy calls me lazy, thinks that I'm a slob. Don't think I got it wrong to be sitting here singing my song. Sitting here in the cornfield, spending my time. Oh yeah, I do believe. You were meant for me. Yeah, you were meant for me.
Sitting here
cornfield, sitting here spending my time, sitting here in the cornfield, skipping on making a dime. I don't think I got it wrong to be sitting here singing my song, sitting here in the cornfield, spending my time. Oh yeah, I do believe, hell yeah, you were meant for me. Oh yeah, if I do believe, hell yeah, you were meant for me. Yeah, you were meant for me. My baby loves shortbread, shortbread. Ooh, my baby loves rye. Like my baby, I eat my shortbread, then I drink my rye. Ooh, my baby loves shortbread, shortbread. Ooh, my baby loves rye. Like my baby, I eat my shortbread, then I drink my rye.
Ooh, my baby loves shortbread, shortbread. Ooh, my baby loves rye. Like my baby, I eat my shortbread, then I drink my rye. Ooh, my baby loves shortbread, shortbread. Ooh, my baby loves rye. Like my baby, I eat my shortbread, then I drink my rye. Then I drink my rye. I do believe, hell yeah, you were meant for me. Oh yeah, if I do believe, hell yeah, you were meant for me. Yeah, you were meant for me. Yeah, you were meant for me.
Dust, 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 I'm covered in dust. Dust, 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 I'm covered in dust. Oh, won't you lay my body down? Lay my body down into the ground. Now you can make the won't you lay my body down? Lay my body down into the ground. Now you can make the sound. Thank you. dust, dust, dust. I'm covered in dust, dust, dust.